Plasma, a life-saving liquid running in our veins, holds the power to transform the lives of patients living with primary immunodeficiencies. Join us on a remarkable journey to uncover the inspiring story of how plasma can be turned into life-saving medicines called immunoglobulins for people with primary immunodeficiencies.
Primary immunodeficiencies are diseases in patients who have a disturbed immune system. And when an immune system is not acting functionally very well, then you will suffer from recurrent infections.
Anyone can be affected by primary immunodeficiency. The most severe cases present at a very early age, but adults can also present with primary immunodeficiency, and it's important to be aware of those.
My name is Iskandar Bin Shalizan. I am going to be 13 this month. I live in Malaysia and I have a hyper-IgM syndrome. I need immunoglobulin therapy to keep me healthy and help my body fight against the infections.
Immunoglobulins are medicinal products that are obtained by fractionation and purification of the human donated plasma. They are essential medicines, life-saving medicines that are used to treat immunodeficiency in patients with immunodepression.
It's very important, a very important essential drug, which is recognized by the World Health Organization.
To understand the full story, let's go back to where it all starts, at a plasma collection center, where individuals voluntarily donate their plasma. The manufacturing process begins with the collection of plasma from thousands of healthy donors. To ensure the highest quality and safety, donors are selected through rigorous screening. Plasma cannot be produced industrially. Ensuring a sufficient supply of plasma therefore entirely comes down to those willing to donate. When donating their plasma, plasma donors offer a gift of life for so many patients in the world.
My name is Peter and I'm a plasma donor. I've been donating plasma since 42 years.
My name is Falk Bieber and I am a plasma donor. I donate plasma for 8 years.
I start donating plasma because I got a tip from a friend. Plasma donation is a part of my life. The process of plasma donation for me is I come here to the center and I will check it, and then I sit on the chair and do my donation, and it's very comfortable. The people are very kind, and after 1.5, 2 hours the donation will be ended, and then I go home, go with friends.
My plasma is important for the development of medicines for patients. My donation is important because it saves lives.
The plasma collected from Peter, Falk, and many other healthy donors is put into bottles at the Plasma Donation Center at low temperatures. Thousands of different donations are needed or pooled to elaborate efficacious immunoglobulins. And this is the first step in the journey of how plasma is transformed into a life-saving medicine. In the manufacturing plant, plasma undergoes a series of processes, which ultimately will result in the production of life-saving plasma-derived medicinal products, such as immunoglobulins. These processes include quarantine, fractionation, purification, formulation, testing, and packaging. Quarantine, as the initial step, means that the plasma batches are held for a period of around 60 days, so testing against blood-transmissible infections can be performed. Once the plasma has been cleared up, it goes through fractionation. Fractionation is a complex process, during which the different therapeutic proteins contained in plasma, such as immunoglobulins, clotting factors, or albumin, among others, are separated. Once the immunoglobulins are separated, they undergo a rigorous purification process so as to obtain a concentrated immunoglobulin solution. Manufacturing companies use different methods for the purification of plasma, for viral removal and inactivation. The removal or inactivation of viral pathogens is a key element that ensures the highest safety of the medicine. The Igs are then filled into vials and bottles that are checked before they are made available to patients. Given plasma fractionation is an intensive and complex production process, it usually takes between 9 to 12 months before immunoglobulin therapies reach the patients who need them. As for any other pharmaceutical products, immunoglobulins are controlled and licensed by regulatory agencies. These agencies ensure that the medicines under their jurisdiction meet the level of safety, efficacy, and quality necessary to be made available to patients.
The regulatory agencies supervise the whole process of medicinal product authorization, starting from before authorization, from clinical trials, during the process, and after approval as well. In the case of immunoglobulins, the regulatory agencies make sure that, for example, the starting material, that is the human plasma, is of high quality, that meets the required criteria, and that it comes from healthy donors. They also ensure that during the manufacturing process, there are steps that efficiently inactivate or eliminate viruses. And they make sure that during production, all the necessary testing is performed. For example, to assure that there is no presence of any impurities or viruses or other agents that could cause adverse reactions to the patients.
Having an effective regulatory system will ensure that only the immunoglobulins that have been evaluated and are of high quality and safety and efficacy standards are going to be made accessible for the patients.
Immunoglobulins are biological products which are produced by different fractionators and are available in different modes of administration. As a result, different immunoglobulins may be tolerated differently by patients, who may also have preferences in terms of the route of administration.
That this is very important for the patient to have the immunoglobulin that suit them for the treatment, meaning they can have subcutaneous or IVIG, intravenous immunoglobulins, and this is very important for them and for the physician to have the choice between the two routes because of the where they live, the patient can value one or the other route, and this is part of the quality of life that is really important for a lifelong treatment.
The route changed because my doctor said that subcutaneous immunoglobulin would be better suited for me. I am currently very happy with the change, as for now I am not off to school so often.
Immunoglobulin therapies are essential medicines that are recognized by many international organizations. They are life-saving treatments and they should be accessed by patients, whether children or adults, and without any financial hardship.
The development of immunoglobulins is only possible thanks to the donation of healthy individuals. The implementation or strengthening of plasmapheresis programs is imperative to meet the growing needs of the patients worldwide.